I think one of the first things I try and get across is when know your pitch rates, and know that you need X amount of yeast for this style of beer or this style of beer. And there's plenty of literature out that out there to figure out what pitch rate you need for what beer. But many times it's not just one package of beer fits, or I'm sorry, one package of yeast fits any beer style or any beer volume. You really need to tailor that pitch rate for the individual style of beer that you're brewing. And so when you're doing that, then either you're buying multiple packages of the yeast or you're making starter cultures. And the biggest mistake, or one of the biggest mistakes I see, are that people will make a starter that's too small, and then they'll let it run for too long. And so it takes about 2 liters, one of our packages in 2 liters will double the culture. And that should finish in about 24 hours, if, well, 18 to 24 hours, it's done. I'll hear stories like, okay, well, hey, I've had my starter, a package into a pint starter, and it's been on my stir plate for 5 days. I'm gonna pitch it, and what you've really done is you've beat the culture up pretty bad at that point. First, you didn't feed it that much, and so you maybe got a half of a doubling, increase of 50%, and then you're just sitting there warm and air is available and it's just burning through its energy reserves, and it's going to be hurting by the time you throw it in your beer. Figure out what pitch rate you want to do, and then work a propagation scheme that's going to get you to that pitch rate, and don't run your starters for too long. Know that when you put one package of yeast into a small amount of liquid, there's a ton of yeast there, and they're going to consume that sugar really, really fast. And then use it quickly, or refrigerate it, decant it, and so then you're just pitching slurry.